So now I want us to start looking deeper, and I start looking at these images and start seeing what are the numeric values at each and every pixel, and what in different ways, what representation do they have, and how can we actually start doing any simple types of computations on it. Here I'm showing a simple image of the mandrel image, the original image here. And to help us kind of look into it, I'm going to actually start zooming into it very closely and start showing you exactly the details that actually would be seen if you were actually that close up to that image, but also start showing you the numerical values associated with an image like this. So here you note I've actually put a small red box inside this image. This is a small red box about 8 pixels by 8 pixels or something like that. Again, I'm showing you just pictorial representations of it. Look at it more as an exercise of looking at how these types of images, what kind of information we have in these images, less at the exact values. This is just now me showing a zoomed in version where the red region is. Now in the next one, I'll show you exactly what the red region looks like, namely this one. Now if you notice here, there is a lot of white area and a little bit of a grayish area and a kind of a dividing line between them, which is kind of where you would see the details of this. And you can see this a much more close up here now. Of course, what you also should be seeing if the your display supports it, a little bit of blockiness at each and every pixels, again, because these are pixels that we have zoomed in and gotten really close to. If I had some magic, and of course I do when I actually look at it computationally, I would be able to look at this image and actually not just look at the image, but the values that exist at each and every pixel. Let me zoom into exactly the level of the red pixel region that we have. And now if you notice, you should be seeing some numbers. And you notice the numbers are like 159, 168, and then lower numbers of 131, 132 here. And approximately there is a little bit of a the same kind of thing here, where white values and a little bit of more gray values. Now again, this is just simply a pictorial way of looking at it. These numbers are not exact, even though I've attempted to match it as closely as possible to this sub-image here. A couple of things we can start doing now, and that is start looking at this image a little bit more carefully and see if we can learn about different intensities in different directions. So here what I've done is I've actually now drawn a line. Basically, what I've done is, remembering these are different columns, and in this way are different rows. I found one row, I've drawn this, and I've actually drawn a plot of the values at that slice. Now, if you now traverse it, so I'm going to start kind of moving in from this way. And if you notice, there are lots of darker values. Of course, there is a lot of change going on. And all of a sudden, when you come up here, there's a lot more higher values. Remember, that lower values kind of designate more of the darker shades of gray or black, and the brighter values much more lighter shades of gray towards white. So white comes in, and here again you see a little bit of change. But now this actually starts telling us a lot more about this image just for that one slice. I also wanted to show that the same slicing can be done in the y-axis. So here, for example, we have looked at the one row, just one row. And if you look at it again, the same kind of stuff. If you come in from the top, there's a lot of kind of various dark values. All of a sudden, we see a lot more white values. And again, coming down to a lot more gray values. So this is basically now start saying is we can start looking at these numbers. Even though the image is shown to us in this form or this form, there are underneath it these values. And these are extremely important values for us. And we can actually kind of start doing various types of visualizations of this. And these basically are just looking at the slices. So looking at this now, you should be seeing that basically we have kind of looked at an image, been able to visualize it in X and Y slices. This should start suggesting, and especially looking at this, is basically this is a two-dimensional representation where each and every point is basically a pixel which has its own intensity value. So the best way to represent this would be a matrix. This already kind of looks like a matrix. It's a two-dimensional array, and each and every element of this matrix is a pixel, and the value of that is basically the intensity value there. So image can be therefore represented as a matrix, and the variance of all the values vary from 0, which is for black, to 255, which is white. So this is a scale that goes from 255 to 0, 0 being pure black, that is no pixel is actually now showing any intensity whatsoever, and white, where the entire pixel is basically showing the maximum intensity, that is pure white. Of course, anywhere in between would be different shades of gray.